Bed Buddies. I'm Paul Roberts, artsy one. We're going to do something different today. One thing I've never done is get something that could sell for a lot ready to go. Right around the turn of the century, when I really started to heavily costume for about 5 years, I kind of got frustrated always being hot, miserable, and sweaty in Batman costumes. And I said, I'd like to go and get together with some of my Bat Buddies in other costumes. And one of the other costumes, of course, was Indiana Jones. One of the other ones was Rick O'Connell from The Mummy, because I had my face exposed. It was cool and comfortable, and I could talk with people and just hang out. So one of the things I needed to do was accumulate a few things. And in that process of accumulation, I found some really cool things and a lot of really cheap things. One of the really cool things that I found, and I'm the only one that has this, is the weapons case from the trunk of the car in the beginning of The Mummy 2. I'm the only one that has this, and I've just treasured it all this time, but I'm thinking of letting it go if it goes for the right price. I don't know what the right price is. I don't buy things to sell them, but this case, I may choose to. We'll see. Regardless of whether it sells or not, I'd be happy to keep this the rest of my life, but I've got to take care of things that are screen-used props and that have a value to the movie legacy of the United States and the world. This one does. I really wanted to get the first one, but I couldn't. There was probably only one made, and a couple dummy ones where he carries them.
But as with many things, I just had to let it go because I couldn't afford to keep it myself. But I enjoyed working with it, and I still have some of the parts.
But this one, I was able to acquire, along with a whole lot of other mummy things, whatever I could afford at the time. So what I did, and what I will do, is equip this with all kinds of things so it looks real, at least as close as it was to the one in the trunk. So I've gone and taken care of this and gotten it all in good shape. I'm going to work on this a little bit more. I've gone over all the things that I have inside of it and around it, and I'm working on those. And I thought, well, let me show some of the processes while I'm doing this. So I thought that's not a bat video, but that'll make a video that some people might be interested in because, heck, all props. This could be a batarang, but it's not. All props kind of have the same types of processes associated with them. Molding, casting, aging, painting, a whole bunch of things. I thought I'd just kind of touch on this. It's kind of a talk-based thing, but maybe a little bit of hands-on too. So that's what this video is going to be about. This is what's on the desk today, Bat Buddies. So every one of these items is a potential mummy item that could go in that pack. Like for instance, he might have gotten one of these swords from the first one. He pulls one out of the bookcase in the fight in the house. He hasn't had the Dragon Emperor sword yet, so we won't fool with that. This wouldn't fit, but he definitely has this if he decided to walk out with it. Probably not, though, because the door came down on Benny and couldn't get in there anymore. But anyway, I've got it. So I've taken some various things that you can get, some typical things of the day. Like some of his comrades on the show were cowboys. So your typical cowboy guns and holsters are included. I hate to part with these. These things are like a lot of money each, just in and of themselves, like $100. That starts to add up. So I'm going to put this together the right way. But for a gun like this, which is a real gun, never do this at home, folks, even if it's a prop, and you know that. But I don't have bullets for this, and I never have. These are the dual-wielding guns that he uses primarily in his dual shoulder holsters, which I also have created. So I'll be using dummies of that. I have this nice Indiana Jones gun from the third movie. I do have bullets for this, so I handle it as if it's loaded. This is the dummy gun. So anything I put in here is gonna be a dummy item. Even these are made out of metal, but they're dummies. Nice little Colt 45, I think that is. Shotgun's too big to go in this. So we have this smaller cutoff shotgun. This is just a really cheap gun. And right now it still looks cheap. Even though I've worked on it once, I'm gonna go ahead and work on this some more and bring it up to the level of the other pieces. So it looks totally real. But I don't know my guns. I think this might be a black powder gun. I'm not sure. I don't know if that would even appropriately be in there. But I kind of just, for my own purposes, put in whatever I had. And now he uses guns like these too. And I don't know what these are called, but they're just black. And that's not good. I'm going to give some aging to that like I do on the utility belts and other things that I've shown you on this channel. These are just solid resin. And then we have all kinds of ammo pouches. You've seen these on a few utility belts. Additional belt, other ammo type pouches. I've got a nice rubber knife that I have not painted up and aged yet. I might do that. And I'm just going to put it together with some things that I can afford if it does sell to let go, because it'll probably be shown by itself and loaded. And if it does go, I want it to have only replaceable things in it. Here's a master of the Indiana Jones Raiders of the Lost Ark gun. This is the one that he throws in the suitcase. You know what a careful fellow I am. But I have a lot of other mummy things that I've also made, like the Rick O'Connell suit outfit, Evie's outfit. I made a mummy costume. It wasn't the right kind of mummy, but I let that go about 20 years ago. I've had a lot of fun with these things. Here's some of the handcuff things for the prison scene before he's released and comes to help them. I've done a couple of mummy videos way down the line if you want to see some of those props talked about a little bit more. So I'm going to get started on this. I already have. I cleaned these all, oiled them, and everything like that. And I want to just bring some things up to a little bit better condition. Like this, I know is the wrong gun for this holster. It's too small. It's just plastic. I want to go in there and work on it a little bit more, show the details of it. But it looks good when it's in the holster. Whoever ends up with this, even if it's me, eventually will continue to work with the items and get them better. Like for instance, I don't have a Thompson. Rick's companion says, I prefer the Thompson. This is one of my favorite things. And like I said, you can see the videos. This is the golf club thing. It's just a club that Jonathan's hitting away at things and the sarcophagus drops down. That's one of my favorite things. And the reason why I have these things is because I knew more than the person having the auction what the items were. Like I've got this great bag, they get out of the dirigible, I think it's called, and he's still got that bag. I've got that bag, there's only one. There's no need to have a bunch of those. It's a hero prop, it's screen used, but I've got it because I know what things are. These were great years about 20 years ago, and I've had this on display all this time. And I've got a lot of antiques and old things from my family. I've got things I've made, I've got things I've acquired, some props, some real. And I kind of like to keep my studio and my office space having these things in it. Like my Batman stuff's only ever been in the cave mostly. It just doesn't look good in Wayne Manor. So I decorate my office as an adventurer. There are a few things I have that are just one-offs, and this is one of them. Here's a cowl that I have that I'm working on right now, and I was gonna do a video on this, showing how to get the texture. I'm the only one that has this cowl because I made it and I've never shared it. So I might have that in an upcoming video. I'm not getting enough attention and views and comments on these things, but I'm doing them anyway, so if I can make them go easy like this one's gonna be, just to tell you what I'm gonna be doing, and then if I just do a little bit of some crafting, maybe I can do a video of showing what I'm doing and then put the final video together and show what it looks like. So right now, I'm just letting you know, this is what's on the desk today. Bat Buddies, let me know that you're out there still. I'm Paul Roberts, Artsy One, and I'll talk to you in an upcoming video.